long-winded with other things, but when it comes to this, years ago, when I was a deacon, there was this pastor named at Faith Tabernacle Baptist Church. And he would get up and he would have the church up here. And the minute he got there, he would sit down. And I went to him one day and I asked him, I said, Reverend Norton, why does it when you get the church going up, you bring it in? He said, son, let me tell you something. Preaching this word, you can only keep people's attention about 10 or 15 minutes. After that, their mind is going to stop wondering. So that's why I do this sometimes. But also, when God says do it, you got to do it.
That's right.
Our scripture was read by my brother this morning from where I'm coming from.
All right.
And I'm going to concentrate on that 24th verse. And that ye be put on new man, the new man,
all right,
which is created after God in righteousness and in holiness.
All right.
If I was to use for a thought, the new man, as I look around St. Paul this morning,
all right,
I see some men in the house.
All right.
These men are new men.
All right.
For we know that we weren't always new men. Because we were out in the world doing any and everything but the will of God.
Right.
When God came into our life,
yes,
he created us to put aside all the foolishness of the world.
All right.
He put aside for us not to go into the places that we used to go. All right. The edges, the highways and byways that we used to sneak around late at night and go into. Because you didn't want nobody seeing you going in there.
All right.
But you got to remember one thing. You might have been hiding from man, but you wasn't hiding from God.
Because
right. God was looking at you right then. And he said to himself, you can run and you can hide, but you can't get away. Because one day, I'm going to turn you into a new man. And how does he turn you into a new man? I believe the 23rd verse said, and being renewed in the spirit of your mind.
All right.
You often hear a pastor talk about the mind. The mind is a thing that can wander all over the land. Bounces from here and there like a rubber ball, boom, 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 from one wall to another. But when you come to the renewing of your mind in Christ, he focused you on him and not the foolishness of the world.
All right.
You can't be a new man if you're down on the corner.
That's right.
With the bottle turned up to your head.
That's right.
You can't be a new man if you're out there in the corner gossiping and doing everything that's not like God.
Right.
You're not renewed in your mind when you do those things. But when your mind is renewed and stay focused on Jesus,
all right,
you're going to be a good man,
right,
walking upright before God, talking about the new man.
That's right.
A new man don't go to the places where he used to go.
All right.
A new man don't go and do the things that he used to do. He don't think about doing evil. He don't think about doing wrong.
Yeah.
What he thinks about is pleasing God through his will and his way.
Right.
The new man is here to stay. The world might not like the new man. But I know one thing. God loves the new man. He loved you so that he gave his only begotten son.
Right.
That whosoever believeth in him shall have everlasting. Even when you wasn't fit to be this new man, he still let his son go to the cross for the new man. I don't know about you, but I'm glad that he turned me into a new man. I'm glad that one day he looked down at a wretch like me.
Yeah.
Wasn't fit to live and wasn't fit to die.
But
he changed my mind.
Yeah.
He renewed my mind. He renewed my thinking. He put me on a path of righteousness. Because see, I was on the path to nothing but hell.
All right.
I had to remember that somebody told me a long time ago. Said they had a dream that they was in an airport. And said they were standing at the gate. And all these people were standing there. And she said to herself, wait a minute. Somebody stopped me. Said, you standing at the wrong gate. Said, you standing at the gate of degradation. You standing at the gates of hell. You standing at the gates of disappointment. Said, they turned her around and put her on the right gate. And that right gate was the love of Jesus. We all were standing at the wrong gate one time. That wrong gate might have got you hurt, but thank God you wasn't hurt. The wrong gate might have got me killed, but thank God you wasn't killed. The new man came out and started working and doing things for God. The new man is a man that don't cheat and don't lie. The new man is a man that his word is bind to God. If he tells you he's going to do something, he's going to do it. The new man, the world may not like, the world may not love, but God loves you. He knows all about you. I'm talking about the new man. You know how well I watch Facebook, and there's a guy by the name of Darby, and he puts up different things. And when he put this thing up, he had a bum laying on the sidewalk. His hair was all grungy and all dirty, and his clothes was all ragged. And someone came by and picked this man up, took him to the barber shop, got him a haircut, took him to a tailor and got him a new suit and put it on him, took him to a hotel and put him up in the hotel. And when that man walked out in front of that stove where he used to lie by, nobody recognized him. Nobody knew it because the new man was standing there. That new man that nobody wanted to touch. Nobody wanted to speak to. Nobody wanted to pray. But now they were praising him. Why? Because the clothes that he had on. Because the haircut that he had. Because of the earthly thing. But I'm telling you, you ought to praise him. The new man. Praise him for what God is doing in it. For what God is having to do. For what God has to say. New man. A new man's church. There's a lot of men out there. One day we pray to God. That day be new man. I don't know about you. But I want to be right. I want to be the man that when I leave this world, that God, when I get up to the pearly gates, when I stand before the judgment box, I can hear him say, well done, my new man. Well done, because you put on the whole armor of God when you were walking down on earth. You did my will. You did my way to the best of your ability. Welcome home, new man. Take your seat. Sit down and rest a little while. Don't be tired. Don't be dismayed when people turn against you, because the new man is going to come out shining like a new shiny dog. The new man. Don't worry about it.
Right.
It's only a few of us. But I tell you one thing. The new man that I see.
Right.
Every time I walk into this house. Is always this. How you doing, bro? That's love. That's a new man. New man. to teach the new man that he put under it. You follow his leadership, and you will become a real good new man. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you.